What is MOTS-C peptide? If you want to understand what MOTS-C is and how it can influence your health, your metabolism, and your endurance, you've come to the right place because this is one of my favorite peptides because of the amount of energy generation that it provides. And so in this video, what I'm going to do is show you how to use MOTS-C, how to activate these genes that you want expressed in natural ways, and also how to stack it with other peptides. So MOTS-C is a very powerful peptide that naturally exists in your body. And if you think of the expression of genes, one of the genes that gets phenotypically expressed in the Japanese population that seem to live longer than other populations is the gene that activates MOTS-C. So what is it? Well, if you've ever exercised and you notice that you sweat when you exercise, and if you have an inability to sweat when you exercise, we gotta fix that. And MOTS-C may be the thing that you need. But what happens is when we put our bodies under stress, stress from hormetic activities or the activities that just apply a little bit of challenge to us, you get this expression of MOTS-C. So MOTS-C is this mitochondrial encoded peptide, and it migrates into the nucleus of the cell. And this is where you get this expression of heat shock proteins. And heat shock proteins are very beneficial for activating recovery. They help the muscle tissue recover faster. And one of the things that you can do is be like the people in Finland who get in a sauna. So MOTS-C can be expressed when we exercise, but it's also expressed when you're in a sauna. Because once again, when there's sweating and when there's heat shock proteins, a little bit of stress on the body, this is one of your body's beautiful mechanisms of counterbalancing the stress. So I look at this as your body's own secret weapon for resiliency. And this is what I've noticed and what hundreds of my clients have noticed when they get on MOTS-C. They're like, I just feel a little more like zesty, and kind of a weird word, but we'll go with it. So zesty is actually when they feel like they've got the energy to do the things that they want to do. One of my clients, he's an AI engineer and he's incredibly intelligent. So intelligent, half the time I don't know what he's saying because he's always in computer terms. But he notices that if he gets on MOTS-C, his blood sugar is far more stable. And he said, when I'm on MOTS-C, I don't get the afternoon drops. I feel more energized when I work out. He likes to do these hot workouts in like the infrared gyms. And he says, I just feel like I can go so much farther. And I also feel like I sleep better. And so he shows me his sleep scores. And sure enough, he sleeps better when he's on MOTS-C. But most importantly, his metabolic system is much more stable. So one of the studies that researchers did when they were looking at MOTS-C is they took participants and they had them exercise. So they put them on a stationary bike and they checked MOTS-C levels before they got on the bike. And then they looked at it 30 minutes after, and then they looked at it again an hour later. And then they tested the MOTS-C levels every hour until they started to see it drop. But what the researchers found is by the time they started exercise, most of the participants had a 500 to 600% increase in MOTS-C, in this peptide in the body that helps produce the secondary energy system, and it activates autophagy. The other thing that they found is that higher expression of MOTS-C lasted 5, in some cases 6 hours after that session of exercise. So it led researchers to hypothesize that MOTS-C is one of the peptides that our bodies use to help create and inform the satellite cells in the musculoskeletal system. So what they did is the researchers said, okay, well, what if we took somebody who was old and gave them MOTS-C? Would they actually be able to have the same expression? Because as we age, that expression gets lower and lower of MOTS-C. Just like with many of the other peptides in our body's expression of those peptides starts to drop as we age. And so what we use peptides to do is it's like a key that unlocks that gene that's been missing. And so researchers, they did this in mice, and what they did is they took old mice, and old mice are typically around 24 months old, and they compared the ability for these old mice to run on a treadmill, and they looked at the distance of the old mice versus the young mice. And the young mice roughly could outrun the old mice by about a factor of 100%. And so then what they did is they took the old mice, they did 7 days of this MOTS-C injections into these mice and then put them on the treadmill. And these old mice could run just as far as the young mice with just 7 days of MOTS-C. Now you may be thinking, like, I've got a mouse that I'm gonna put in a race really soon. How can I get MOTS-C? Well, you're in the right place. Okay, so maybe we don't put mice in races, but one of the great things that MOTS-C can do in humans is we can activate our body's ability to have more endurance. So one of the metrics that I look at is every year I go and I climb Puke Hill. And so for those of you who live in Utah and you know the Wasatch Crest Trail, maybe you've mountain biked it. Well, there's an area and we call it Puke Hill because you basically are riding up this fire road and you got about a 2,000 foot climb until you get to the top. And it's just a slug. You know, you're just like, you're so like your legs are burning and your lungs are fried. Most people are walking part of the way, but when you get to the top, whether you're walking or riding, it's just as hard. I actually find it's easier to just bike the whole way up, but you get to the top and people literally throw up. And so I always warn my friends every year, I'm tracking my distance. How fast can I make it up to the top? And what kind of exertion is required? And what I find when I use MOTS-C, I'll use another peptide called ARA-290, which is an EPO peptide. And then I'll, you know, usually use some kind of growth hormone peptide. And what I find is that when I use that, my time has gone down. Every year I'm trying to beat my previous time. And MOTS-C, when I have that, I can always shave off about 3 or 4 minutes on my time, which is more than 10%. So, you know, yes, it's an N of one study, but for me, I find that I can actually have about 10 to 15% more endurance. And then I've also seen that in some of my endurance athletes. I have one of my clients and she's a cyclist and she rides all over and she's getting ready to be on USA team. And but she rides professionally. And when she's on her off season, when she can use peptides, she notices that her times are so much better. Her recovery is better. And MOTS-C is one of those great peptides. So it's a mitochondrial peptide. And if you want to activate its response, you'll also want to think about using substances like urolithin A or CoQ10, using N-acetylcysteine so you have better glutathione production. And then methylene blue, because when you have methylene blue in there, you're activating what's called that electron transport chain so that your mitochondria get this nice expression of energy. And so for those of you who love the idea of being able to help balance the body's healing systems, having better endurance, having better muscular fitness, and most importantly, a better metabolic function, because MOTS-C, it also helps stabilize that insulin resistance, so your blood sugar gets stable. So what the research shows with MOTS-C is it's like exercise in a bottle. It's the closest peptide that we know of that mimics the impact of exercise. And that is the holy grail in medicine right now, is what is that agent that can mimic exercise, because there's no better expression in your body than what happens when we exercise. And so MOTS-C has been shown to reduce inflammation, increase energy, increase your glucose utilization. And if you love what you've learned about MOTS-C and you want to go even deeper, then go to my video on the best alternatives for Ozempic for weight loss, and I'll see you there.